Can you tell me about the local issues within Ontario?
Well, on a local scale, specifically in Ontario, there are three main issues to address, which are irresponsible waste disposal, illegal poaching, and improper fishing practices. So let's talk about irresponsible waste disposal. David, I'm sure you and I have been guilty of throwing away batteries in the normal garbage bin or dumping harsh chemicals down the toilet. Am I right?
I don't know what you're talking about. Okay, yes.
It's okay, Dave. It's a common thing many people do. However, by irresponsibly throwing away batteries and pouring chemicals down the drain, toxic heavy metals such as lead or mercury, as well as highly corrosive acids, can leach from landfills and go into the water systems within Lake Ontario. These contaminants are very lethal to fish, even at lower concentrations. Also, because these fish and other organisms bioaccumulate the toxins that they are exposed to, we are susceptible to the toxic effects as well when we consume them.
That is a very good point, David.
Thanks. In terms of illegal poaching, there has been an increase in the global demand for sturgeon caviar. The international demand for caviar has been estimated to be nearly 2 million kilograms per year, according to the World Wildlife Organization. For our viewers who don't know, caviar are fish eggs found in sexually mature female sturgeon, which can be sold up to hundreds or even thousands of dollars, depending on its grade. As you can tell, this makes a very profitable and lucrative business. Unfortunately, according to the Ministry of Natural Resources, majority of the illegal hunting occurs in Lake Ontario to supply this demand. As a result, by removing reproductive females from the water, it can significantly decrease the population's ability to recover. And lastly, for improper fishing practices, I've noticed that anglers fishing within Ontario may not be aware of the life history of lake sturgeon. And because of this, anglers may take juvenile sturgeon home, since they are easier to carry and cook. But like you had mentioned earlier, David, sturgeon takes about 15 years to reach adulthood. By removing the vulnerable juveniles from the water, this greatly impedes the population from recovery.
Well, looks like we haven't had too much luck fishing today, David. Maybe we should go upstairs and take a break.
You know what? That sounds like a good idea. Let's pack up and go upstairs.
Well, David, that was a fun fishing trip.
Yes, it was.
Did you have a good time?
Yes, I had a great time. We should do this again sometime, David.
Definitely.
So, David,
yes.
I've got some questions from when we were fishing.
Mm-hmm.
You've already addressed the broad-scale problems that are facing the lake sturgeon.
Right.
However, I was wondering, what are some solutions to these?
Well, that's a great question. In 1997, there was a study done. Basically, experimenters went to the St. Lawrence River and built an artificial spawning shoal. Basically, they recreated the conditions of a spawning shoal and allowed lake sturgeon to come in and breed.
That sounds rather interesting. I was wondering, even though that addresses the problems and solutions on a broad scale, what about on more of a local scale? What are some things that individuals can do within Ontario to make an impact on the conservation of lake sturgeon? It's a
fantastic question, David.
On a local scale, recreational fishing is very popular in Ontario. However, anglers may not be handling fish correctly, and this may affect the health of sturgeon. Some suggestions would be to handle fish with wet hands to prevent removing their natural slime coat. Also, while taking pictures of sturgeon, anglers should do their best to minimize the fish's exposure out of the water. Lastly, anglers should try to practice catch and release methods.
So, I have some other questions for local solutions. What about if I was to throw something out in the trash? Could I throw out batteries? Is that appropriate? For example, I have a remote control with me.
Yes.
And within this are my AA batteries. And I want to know if it's a problem if I was just to put these within the trash.
That's a great question, David. And I would recommend, David, is to take those batteries and bring them to your local hardware store, and I'm very sure that they have a designated disposal area for them.
Oh, okay. I will be sure to do that next time, David. Mm. And also, other local solutions, could they include being more careful with just regular items like making sure that we recycle within Ontario, or making sure that we throw away regular trash items into the proper bins, right?
Correct. So many people may be, you know, on the go, very rushed, and might not put the effort in separating their recyclables from their normal trash. So making a simple effort in actually throwing away your trash and recycling your waste would be a great way to ensuring cleaner water quality. It's important to mention would be using vinegar, actually. Vinegar is a great way to clean your house. It's a great solvent. It deodorizes your house. It's very mild, and it neutralizes in water.
So, now that we've looked at some different solutions, I think it's important that our viewers are aware that they themselves can make influences on the conserving of lake sturgeons themselves. So, the cumulative effects of all the things that we do in our everyday lives can make a very strong impact on the conservation of these lake sturgeon species.
My name's Matt.
And my name's Dan. Thank you for watching this video, and we hope you enjoyed it.
It'll be great if you guys can apply some of the conservation methods we outlined. And if you have any suggestions or comments about conservation, please post it in the comment box below.